Greetings everyone. Myself Shivaji from IIT Hyderabad, India, along with co-author Professor Ravi Mukashi Punekar from IIT Guwahati, India, we are presenting paper titled Intervening on Building as a Product and Habitation as a Service in Contemporary Urban Settings for Adaptive Microhabitation Design, Indicative Global Case Studies. 38 million new homes were built as against 24 million new households which were there in existing in year 2015 in India. But on contrary, if you see, there is a shortage of approximately 20 million homes in India in the same year. So this is a very paradoxical situation. So the supply is surplus, but still the service which was required, the supply which was needed for the needy people was not made, even if the surplus supply was there. And in this particular demand and supply game, if you see the economics of real estate, how is it working in India, the most hit group among this supply game belongs to the EWS, economically weaker section. So 95.6% of the housing shortage was under EWS category, which affects the people from the lower strata. As you can see in these pictures from the below or on the side, so these are the common shots available from the urban areas in any urban city in the India currently, if you go to Mumbai, Delhi, Chennai, any other places. So what is the way forward? So if we refer to the SASE P 2016, the concept of compact living, high density with mixed use land use, access to facilities by choosing of either end product delivery or service rendered by the product. So in this case, the need fulfillment, how it can be given? So could there be unit of satisfaction which can be served from the field of architecture? So if we consider architect as a product or service, so that is a big question. So if we see compared to the product, which is kind of a traditional lineage which is coming since like time immemorial, so any piece of architecture building is seen as a traditional position, belongs to somebody. It may be occupied at the time of the like a need or may not be. So there is a paradigm shift observed in the habitation when the service sector has evolved meeting the needs of the people. So in case of if you see architecture as a service, so it is certainly used in the given circumstances. What could be the probable benefits? This would have distributed model of service delivery and exert lesser consumption and environmental impact due to wider distributions of users per unit. So users per unit of traditional space consumption is of the key role over here, because it includes more number of people as to be distributed in the same unit of the habitation. So another one, an increased social equity can be achieved in the current scenario of economic disparity and affordability challenges. As we see, the lower income group, EWS group, is the most hit. So if they can be included into this fold, this could improve the social equality. And in the next benefit, a unit of satisfaction in habitation as a service can be defined as an end user having access to the living space for a given time frame. So may not be on a permanent basis, but on a temporary basis. So how can we explore the way forward? At present, it may not look like a permanent solution, but at least it offers a temporary relief to the crisis of homelessness and the shortage of homes and habitable spaces in and around urban areas and semi-urban areas, and mostly for the people who are out of the affordable limit in the urban areas, and for their like a shorter time duration of requirement. So what is the role of designers over here? That they can open and dialogue, and they can try to address the social challenges and social problems in their own creative ways. So this effort may not be sufficient in its present form to fulfill the all of this crisis, but at least it can establish a dialogue, it can start a conversation to solve this bigger problem which is there in India as well as in every major economy or every populated country, mostly belonging for the developing world in the world. So if we see like a common advertisements given in the newspapers, what are the people looking for? So for example, this particular advertisement, if you see, this is looking for 3-bedroom flat in a co-housing rented incorporation, shared laundry, TV and playroom, collective garden, possible car sharing also, common kitchen. So this kind of links are already given over there, the what kind of requirement people are looking for. So in this kind of scenario, there are two things which evolve in the community housing and as an extended home. So in this particular scene, if you see, the sharing the domestic resources could be the key thing to handle the community housing infrastructure and how it can evolve. So the key point over here is collaborative services, how people can come together and collaborate on sharing products as well as their services. In the second option, if you see, extended home, so whereby extending the activities of an household and outsourcing it to the collective infrastructure. For some examples of these, we will see in the next slides. So if I take architecture as a service, so there are several this, if we take intervention area consider it as a main domain, so there are certain intervention areas, probably six are coming in this particular study: building and construction, process and system integration engineering, building automation and BIM, software development, energy and utility, and facility management. So these could be the probable intervention areas for considering architecture as a service and in its domain. Second, if you come to the intervention areas of spaces as far as architecture as a service is concerned, so two major points are evolving over here in the community housing and extended home. So under community housing, several smaller activities can be integrated, like multi-user laundry, playgrounds, gardens. So these three activities we see already being shared in the community housing areas. So what could come up as a new activity is the, like a neighborhood library, parking facilities, and in the extended home, like party places, and new activities, new collaborative activities could be started, combining like two different activities, like laundry restaurant and guest rooms also in the community housing spaces. So if we see in this particular actually this scenario, so there are some indicative case studies from across the world which we have been seeing for some time. So we will present some case studies from Japan, India, Hong Kong and New York, like how micro habitats are being planned in urban settings to solve the crisis of like a housing sector. First example comes from a long time back, which was completed in year 1972 by architect Kisho Kurakawa. This is the Nakagin capsule tower. This was actually a hotel building which was planned long back. It is a mixed use building which had a commercial in the lower floors and a hotel structure on the above floors. So it has composed of like two towers, 11 and 13 floors. So this particular building actually gives example of how this concept started at that particular time. If you see the interior of it, it has 140 self-contained prefabricated capsules, and the sizes of it were 2.5 meter by 4 meter with a 1.3 meter diameter window at one end, which functions as a small living and office space also for the people. It can be connected and combined with to create larger spaces as well. And as you can see in the picture, some basic requirements like telephone, TV, oven, these kind of things are also fitted inside this activity, a capsule hotel. Some more pictures from like other hotels which started replicating this model in their own ways. So a capsule hotel which came in Osaka, so this is a modular plastic or a fiberglass block, roughly by 2 meter by 1 meter by 1.2 meter in dimension. So fitted with television, electronic console, wireless internet, and even a common luggage keeping area, washrooms and shared spaces. So these are some shots of that capsule hotel, as you can see, shared with the common aisle, and there are capsules lying on top of each other, and there are multiple capsules inside a given space. So in a way, if you see, this increases the density of occupants in any given particular space. This is a recent example from Osaka, Hotel 9H. It offers extremely small rooms, capsule, intended to provide cheap basic overnight accommodation for around $18 to $37 per night. Some more examples and how design has helped this scheme, this design, to evolve into a contemporary and trending style. This is again integrated with technology, and you can operate it with your smart card and even your app in your phone. Similar examples have started coming up across the world, and the recent one is in the India also, in the city of Mumbai. This is Urban Pod Hotel. So this hotel actually uses the same concept in the contemporary setting, These are the urban parts which are kept inside this particular hotel. So each of these units can house one person at a time, and they are fitted with HVAC system, entertainment system, music system, laundry and everything. It looks very sci-fi, and these are prefabricated from the companies, and they are installed over in this particular space. Okay, if we come down to the micro apartments in concrete pipes designed to ease Hong Kong's housing crisis. So in this particular scenario, if you see in the urban setting with an innovative approach, how these two concepts have been combined to evolve a new set of like designs which is fitting in this congested urban areas to house more number of people in a very densely packed urban spaces. This has been called as urbanovation. So as you can see in this 3D rendered images, these are filling the negative spaces which are very common in any urban cities and urban areas. So this Hong Kong studio James Law Cybertecture, they have developed a prototype of low cost stackable micro homes in concrete pipes which could slot into gaps between city buildings. As you can see right below the bridges or between two buildings, the dead spaces. So those spaces can be reutilized in a very productive way, and more number of people can be brought in under the main fold of living. So as you see, as you can see, even for the circulation, this all of these units are linked with the common staircases and corridors, and they are also fitted with the smartphone applications and can be unlocked by using your smartphones. This is actually a rendered model of that unit. Here we can see the dimensions and the equipments and the working files of this particular design. And this is the real-time pictures of this urbanovation from the interior side. So you can see on the one side there is a laying cot, and on the other side there is worktop and some storage facilities also with glass openings. So this was the prototype created over there. So mainly this concept appeals to the young people who can't afford private housing. Similar is example coming from New York, parts from New York. So this example has been given by Framleg, which proposes parasitic hexagonal pods to sleep the New York's homeless. So as we are all aware of, New York is a cosmopolitan city, but it has a huge number of homeless people also. So what about them? How they can be brought into the main fold of the society? So as you can see in this 3D rendering image, so the dead facades of the buildings, they can be used to erect these hexagonal pods on their dead surfaces as scaffolding, and each pod can house one person at a time. Some more renderings of the same design, as you can see on the left side in the night or the late evening time. So empty walls could be covered with these honeycomb like clusters of pods to house the city's growing homeless. This is the proposition given by the Framlab. So the concept of this cluster living on the vertical lots, it creates temporary shelters on the dead spaces and the dead walls using scaffolding onto the windowless facades. Further, the technological advancements can be brought into the execution by using like a prefabricated and 3D printed parts of this particular units, using lightweight materials like aluminium shells and all, and using like recycled polycarbonate and stuff. So this is fully modern, using construction techniques, adopting technology in its operation, lesser power consumption, ventilation, heat and sound insulation, wireless health monitoring, clean surfaces, smart mood lighting, data outlets, ample storage and lockable entrance. So these are the common features integrated into this particular design, which can come as a savior for the homeless of the cities. So our role as designer over here, this effort may not prove totally sufficient for this need, but at least it is important for architects and designers to be part of the conversation. And it is critical that the design community is part of this social development. So the challenges which are popping up over at this stage are majorly falling under two categories of geographical challenges and temporal challenges. So the evolution and development of design revolves around these two challenges to function over time. So if you take help of like a creative planning, so in this particular diagram, the emotions and behavior of any individual corresponds to the society, which goes further and reacts with the infrastructure and shaped by the ecosystem. So all four of these layers, they interact in a integrative way, in a cohesive way, and the multiple like a four layers, and they correspond and they shape each other. So this design process can be taken forward, and habitation can be taken as a service, and habitation will be served. So what we can take ahead of this particular research topic is to frame an umbrella approach towards design and development of living systems for inclusivity in serving habitation to the humanity. Thank you all.